So Shannon, which potential 8 seed would be the biggest threat for the Lakers?
I mean, Skip, right now we're looking at the Grizzlies, the Blazers, the Pelicans, Kings, Spurs, Suns. And I'll be honest, Skip, I don't see any of these teams posing a roadblock for the Lakers. Mm. The only team that I could see possibly getting a game is because they got a guy that can get hot and go for 50-60, and that's Dame. That's the Blazers. Other than that, I don't think the Grizzlies, the Pelicans, the Kings, the Spurs, Suns. Mm. Nah, they're 17-2 against, combined against those teams. They lost to the Blazers, Skip. You remember Dame went bonkers, but that was right after the death of Kobe Bryant. And they lost to the Grizzlies on a road trip, third game in 4 nights. So I'm going to be honest, none of these teams pose a potential threat to me. I don't fear any of these teams. Obviously, it's going to be different, Skip, because there's really no home court advantage. You're going to be in a centralized location with no fans. It's basically going to be a scrimmage. That's basically what it's going to be like. It's going to be like you are practicing. The only difference is you're playing another team. It's going to be like a practice in your own gym where you're scrimmaging, okay, LeBron, you, AD, and yada, yada, and y'all take on Kuzma and these other guys. Mm. That's what it's going to be like, but you're playing on another team. Mm. So no fans. But all that being said, and it's happened now, Skip. We've seen, you know, the Warriors beat the Mavs a 1-8 matchup. The Nuggets were the first to do it. They beat the Supersonics, mm-hmm. Skip. But if I'm not mistaken, that was the best 3 out of 5 series back in the mid-90s. Mm-hmm. So for me, I don't see it happening. LeBron is going to have ample rest. Everybody's coming in the same. They'll be ready to play. But I don't see any of those teams that could possibly be an 8 seed that could cause the Lakers any problem. I don't see anybody getting more than a game, and that would be the Blazers.
I'm now sensing dangerous overconfidence in my man, Shannon Sharpe, that is going to be contagious for LeBron and everybody around LeBron. We got this. I'm not sure you got this.
That ain't what I said, Skip. I said of the teams, you said the 1-8 matchup. I don't see a team that can knock the Lakers off in a 1-8 matchup. That's
okay.
What I said.
All right. Quick point of order before I give you my answer to this question. You realize the NBA is not shrinking from the prospect of they're going to go head-to-head with the National Football League with their playoffs going into October, right?
Yeah.
Game 7 could be as late as into mid-October, right?
Well, you better not put one of them games on a Monday or Sunday.
I don't know, because I think they're going to have to.
You better not put
it. I think you have to. So here we go. We'll just see how popular the NBA really has become. Okay, back to the question. There are two teams that pose huge threats to your team. In the first one, if you want experienced firepower, we're looking at the Portland Trailblazers because this team is deep in experienced firepower that has not clicked yet this year because they're 29-37 so far, and they just lost 8 of their last 12 games.
Right.
Beware the Blazers because, speaking of Damian, he's averaging career highs, 29 points and 8 assists. He has not yet in his career had a huge playoff series where he really announced his superstar presence. Yeah. So beware. What if your team comes out a little rusty? Remember, they're going to have a play-in tournament, so they're going to get a head start on you.
Yeah.
So they're going to get a running start into this game. They will have worked up their early sweat. They will have worked their kinks out. And all of a sudden, in game one of the first round of the playoffs, your guys might have to deal with Damian, 29-8. CJ's 23-4 assists. And then guess who's back? Nurkic is back.
Why did he get
Nurkic? He got up out of his body bag. He emerged out of his body bag at 7 feet, 280 pounds, whatever he is. He is back.
Yep.
He is alive, and he's back to get a little revenge. And Zach Collins is back. He missed almost the whole year. He is 6'11", 240 pounds, and he can shoot it. And I'm going to remind everybody that Hassan Whiteside is right now leading the NBA in blocks, and he is second in rebounds.
Yep.
Is that good?
Yeah.
So if you get some added length and strength inside with Nurkic and Zach Collins on top of Hassan Whiteside, and then there's this guy, dearly forgotten, this guy named Melo. Do you remember that guy? As in Carmelo Anthony?
Yeah.
Do you remember?
Yeah.
He's just averaging 15-6. Not all bad. He knows how to play. He knows how to. He's not afraid of LeBron James, right?
Yeah.
And Trevor Ariza is on that team. There's a tough guy for you. Again, near the end of his career, but there's toughness there, and there's potential explosion there. Now, let's get to my favorite storyline here. The best narrative in all the NBA You know what it would be?
Zion.
Oh, if you want young guns coming with vengeance, if you want all the traded, shunned Lakers getting even with LeBron James, this would be the story of the year in the NBA. So let's quickly examine what the Pelicans have to offer right now. Zion, they're 11-9 since Zion actually started playing post-knee problems, right?
Yep.
He is averaging 24-7, but more importantly, would you believe that Zion, if you take all the players in the league averaging 15 or more shots per game, all of them, he's number one in field goal percentage through 20 games.
Yeah.
Almost 60%.
Mm-hmm.
They can't stop him.
Right.
Okay, so that's what you're dealing with. He is showing you right away he is legit. He is not undersized. He's not a tweener. They can't stop him from getting to the rim. I don't think the Lakers could stop him. In every big game that he plays, he is not afraid of the brightest light. In fact, the brighter the light, the more he shines. That's just me. Would you believe that Lonzo Ball, over the last five games before our hiatus, would you believe he averaged in those five games 21-8-8? Are you kidding me? That's Lonzo. He was arriving right on time, just ahead of what could be a play-in tournament that they win. They get hot, they win it, and they get revenge on the Lakers because Brandon Ingram, career highs so far this year, 24-6-4. That'll work.
Yeah.
Drew Holiday's averaging 20-7 assists. That's not bad. J.J. Redick is shooting 45% from the three-point line. Will that work? I'd say yes. Josh Hart, one of the toughest-minded guys in the league, not the most talented, averaging 10-7. How about Derek Favors? Averaging 9-10 rebounds a game. Melly comes off the bench and will hit big threes for them. And Jahlil Okafor, 8-4. They've got depth. Those two kids, Nikhil Alexander-Walker and Jackson Hayes, they have flashes of brilliance, the two rookies.
But you know what I didn't hear you mention?
No.
Then they got LeBron or AD. So that's all we need.
They got Zion.
Do you remember what we did to Zion? Do you remember what old Goat James did?
No, I don't.
He dunked on Kuzma. And then LeBron pulled up from half court. Said, put that in your pipe and smoke it before we go to halftime.
Wouldn't it be something if all those shunned, scorned Lakers, LeBron's going to trade you, LeBron's going to trade you, right? What if they just got up for this? What if they steal game one? There's no home court. Nobody cares. It's quiet. It's dead quiet in there. And all of a sudden, the kids are going crazy all around LeBron. And LeBron's saying, man, I'm at the end of my 17th year, and I'm a little rusty here. My joints are a little creaky. I can't get back in the flow.
Oh, he can get back in the flow. Oh, you said he ain't got all the minutes on it. Oh, he went well rested. Yeah, but he been putting that time in the gym. I've been watching. I've been following him on IG Live. Oh, he put that time in.
Is he?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
100.
Is he putting in those 5 minutes that go on IG Live?
No. We put time in. And, Skip, you do realize, I mean, they're gonna have some ball game. I mean, even the other teams are going to be playing some. You make it seem like everybody else gets to play and the Lakers are just patiently waiting. That ain't how we do it. We're going to get like 10 games in. Y'all do what y'all need to do, and we're going to take care of y'all.
Hey. If you put the traded Lakers versus LeBron up against Monday Night Football, I'm torn about that one. I might be watching. I got both TVs going on that one.
It all depends on who's on Monday Night Football. Skip, we got a lot of storylines this year.
You got
Tom and Tampa.
I know. We got Tom.
You got Mahomeboy. You got Lamar.
Yeah. Actually, the second best story in pro football is Tom and Tampa. The third best is Tom and Tampa. The fifth best is Tom and Tampa.
You're asking an offer, like I said, Skip, if you can, schedule a game, have them on like a Tuesday or Wednesday.
Yeah.
Or even Thursday Night Football, Skip, does 10 million.
I don't know. I think I'm starting to make you sweat a little bit.
No, I ain't worried about that.
Yeah.
Oh, go James. He ready for this moment.
Really?
Who you thought?
Oh, you know what? That's right. He's been riding his bike through West Hollywood. He's ready. That's it. That cinches. I back off. I desist. The case is closed. LeBron's been bike riding.
Skip, you remember in 92, Rod Thorne, one of the first calls that he made about the Olympic team was old Michael Jordan, right?
Yeah.
When they thought about resuming this season, who you think Adam Silver jumped on the phone with first?
Chris Paul.
Go leader. Go James.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.